What's happening, people? And once again, welcome back to youtube.com/CubCamTV for this, another edition of Cub Reacts. Right about now, we're getting into something very exciting indeed as Burna Boy joins Black Sherif for the second Sermon remix. Now, I believe the original version of this from Black Sherif is sat on around 8 million views after not a very long period of time at all. This one's been huge. Definitely one that I missed whilst we were doing the sort of hiatus period on the channel. But yeah, very much excited to get into this one. Again, really looking forward to it. As always, if you are new to the channel, please make sure you're hitting the subscribe button on the right-hand side of the page, turning notifications on, leaving a like, leaving a comment, all of that good stuff. I believe Black Sherif is based in Ghana. So yeah, as I said, the original of this one is absolutely blown up. Really cool sounding tune. I had a quick listen to that one earlier before getting into this. But yeah, I'm excited to do it. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Yeah, it's got a bit of a bit more of a drill kind of vibe to it. I love the vocal though. It's so cold, man. Again, the emotion you can hear within the vocal line on this is absolutely crazy. I think there's something about a very slightly electronically edited vocal on this that gives it this crazy kind of sense of epicness, this sense of depth. Again, the reverb's really nicely processed. Again, the instrumental, I love the sort of direction on it. Again, the sort of skippy nature, again, taking influence from the drill sound, but taking it somewhere completely different as it goes. Really clean. You can't not move to it either. Now this is the crazy bit, bro. I listened to the original of this earlier, and the first verse is pretty much the same as this. It's the same instrumental, same structure as far as I'm aware. There might be a couple of little differences, but overall it's pretty much the exact same theme. I'm still bopping around. Like, it's crazy. The energy levels we're getting from this lead vocal line from Black Sherif is absolutely crazy. I love the instrumental. Again, taking, as I said, influences from the sort of drill sound, but taking it somewhere completely different. It's a lot more stripped back. The drums seem to be a lot louder. Those hi-hats seem to be a bit sharper than you would normally hear in a lot of drill stuff. And again, the sort of sweeping nature, I want to say, of that 808 bassline below is absolutely crazy. And I think Sherif sits crazily well on top of this sound. His vocal range, the actual pitch he works with, the texture within his voice just sits so cleanly above it. This is sounding crazy. Yeah, I'm aware. Silence for a minute. Rest in peace to Sister Maria. Yeah, those little keys just being thrown in there as well. It's just simple things done really well. Like, how you can listen to this and not pull a screw face is absolutely crazy to me. Like, there's tunes that come out in the UK on a daily basis, like trying to achieve this level of emotion, this level of kind of hype, I suppose, this level of kind of musical completion, that just get nowhere near it, but still trying to do a similar thing. I think Black Sherif has absolutely smashed this first verse. Again, so much energy. The passion you can hear within his voice is absolutely crazy. It's actually amplified by being slightly auto-tuned, ever so slightly. Again, it's never a bad thing for me. I love hearing electronic vocals. I think it gives them an entirely different texture and direction. What I am interested in on this is where Burna's going to take his verse, more than anything else, because obviously we know Burna is very versatile. We've heard him on Heady One tunes. We heard him on a tune with Polo G not too long ago. We've also heard him pretty much traverse the entire realm of kind of Afrobeat music and amapiano and sort of similar surrounding sounds. So it's going to be really interesting to see where he goes with this one. I quite like this visualizer as well. Oh, the chorusing, bro. Like, getting that much emotion is not easy. The chorusing is crazy. If you are new to the channel, I always say this when we review someone new for the first time. This channel is pretty much based around sort of musical breakdowns and, I suppose, analytical kind of approaches to the production side of tracks from around the world. So yeah, if that's not necessarily your thing, feel free to click off, but we will be pausing a fair bit. We will be breaking down individual elements of the tune rather than just kind of sitting here listening. Not as much of a focus on lyricism as well, because obviously there's going to be a lot of languages that I don't necessarily speak. week that we do react to, but I have such an interest in kind of breaking down the technicalities of kind of international music production, which is my back where my background's based. So yeah, this is sounding crazy so far. Again, the energy through the roof. Right, Burna, what we saying?
From Blacko, everybody knows my man though. The vandal, hopping out the shit, I'm Rambo.
Oh, man. The most versatile, probably right now. When you look at a lot of different artists on a global scale, I genuinely can't think of many people that are more versatile as regularly as Burna. Like, we've seen this guy pop onto so many different types of tunes. Obviously, we've seen the collaborations with the people like Ed Sheeran. We've seen collaborations with Justin Bieber. We've seen collaborations with big pop scale names. We're also seeing things like this. We're seeing collaborations with Heady One. We're seeing collaborations with Black Sherif. We're seeing collaborations with Polo G. A bit more of a sort of underground nature to a lot of what they're doing. So when you kind of compare him to kind of anyone else on a global scale, a couple of years ago, 2019, I think I said it was, he was the guy for features over the course of the year. Anybody was my favorite tune of 2019. I've said it in a lot of different videos on this channel. But the versatility and the instant impact that Burna Boy gives is possibly ranking amongst the best in the world currently. It's crazy.
I'm on the move like a camo. I get love for the jungle and the jungle. Yeah. And stuff for the lad, they hate on me, but alhamdulillah, I'm good. Woo. From a young buck up in a back road jeep with the brook to brook too.
Yeah!
This is what I do. Don't get it confused.
Oh, I love the fact that he's done the back road G reference, man. Like, when we're looking at the UK at the moment, artists that are actually coming out of the UK and doing big things worldwide. For me, you've got Pussaloo, you've got Backrow G, and there's a couple of others kind of bubbling away at the moment, but those are the two for me that really do stand out. Ever since I heard my family with both of them on, the fact that Burna's kind of recognising that, I don't think Burna's collaborated with Backrow. They might have done. Maybe it's one that's just completely slipped by me, which would be bizarre because I'm such a big fan of both of them. But I know Backroad's collabed with Olamide, I believe, and he's collabed with a couple of other international heads, but I don't think they've collaborated. But it's just sick to see, obviously, Burna showing the salute to the UK. A little fact I'll always drop, he actually went to the uni up the road from me, up at Sussex Uni. So yeah, it's crazy.
Yes, I'll be a gorilla, but you cannot lock me in the zoo. This we can come.
The fact that he's able to replicate is crazy. Woo! Yeah, crazy verse, man. Crazy verse from Burna. Again, the energy has been replicated. Obviously, the hook and the first verse from Black Sherif are both very, very high. Like, the energy levels are high, the passion levels are high, the musicality of the verses as well, with the melodies they're using and the harmonic structure behind it are both very, very high. This is crazy, man. I think with a verse like that, when you kind of get brought onto a tune like this that has done so well, and then you kind of arrive and go, cool, I'm going to do Burna on this, you have to match the energy. And I think that's exactly what he did, both in style and just the pure kind of mastery of his own vocal range. Crazy, man. I love the melodies that he's using. Crazy. Just a little note as well, on those keys we're hearing over the chorus block, they're really subtle, but they're doing a lot. Like, behind the scenes, they are really, really doing a lot. There's these little kind of dun-dun, dun-dun-dun-dun, dun-dun, 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 dun-dun-dun, dun-dun, in the background. And they're quite syncopated sounding keys. But again, they add an extra level of depth. They almost add like a... They give the tune a feeling like, oh, we're now onto the next level. We're onto this sort of... They almost solidify the fact that we are moving between sections on the tune. They allow basically transitioning between sections, between bridges, chorus, and verses. And you need a little musical element like this, which is so... on a tune like this, which is so vocal heavy, like the majority of the melody is being provided by the vocals and a little bit by the bass line below, but it's primarily the vocals that are giving the melodies. Again, it's a really cool piece of production more than anything else.
Tell them, mommy, I've been on the road and I've been doing this shit alone. I've been my deuce everywhere I go.
Oh, see my bridge, bro. really got that mommy dope. Study busting up on my phone. Casanova shit. Again, you can hear me on a dog with life on your like on a techie level, like there is very much not much going on behind that vocal. You've got again those very subtle keys. A little bit of movement from the bass line, but pretty much the majority of the mid-range melody is coming from Black Sherif's vocal. Again, so this tune is so drenched in vocal melody, having tiny little melodic elements makes it even bigger. Like, you don't want to over-egg the pudding. You don't want to add too much extra on top. Crazy, crazy stuff. This is, as a collaboration, this is wicked. Obviously, a lot of the tune comes from the original, which I realise we haven't actually reviewed on the channel. So we're sort of using this as a double-up opportunity to do both, hence why the video is a little bit longer. Oh, the harmonies. The harmony is through the roof, man. Crazy. Crazy, crazy tune. What a link up this one is. Black Sherif again alongside Burna Boy for the Second Sermon remix. Go and check out the original as well. A lot of the original tune is featured on this tune. I think they've just kind of expanded the composition to allow more room for Burna Boy to step in. And again, match the energy. I think Burna does a fantastic job of matching Sheriff's energy across this one. Really, really kind of cool take on the idea of collaboration, almost stepping into Sheriff's world. We see this a lot with Burna. He's able to move around and traverse different sounds. But even next to Burna being as good as he is, I still think Black Sherif kind of takes the cake on the tune. I think his vocal is outstanding. I think it's kind of groundbreaking in the way he's doing things as well. Wicked link up. Very much enjoyed this one. So there we go. If you did enjoy this technical analysis and musical breakdown, please do get involved by hitting that subscribe button on the right-hand side of the page, turning notifications on, leaving a like, leaving a comment, all of that good stuff. And of course, do feel free to get involved in the channel by leaving your requests in the comment section down below. Whenever we review a new artist on the channel, a lot of people ask for requests, so please get them in the comment section down below. I read every single one, and we run a regular series on the channel called the Requested Series, where I run through tracks that you guys are suggesting. So please do get involved. Enjoy the rest of your Wednesday as well. And yeah, we'll see you all next time. Catch you later.
Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel right now, CubCamTV. Stay locked.